1 Corinthians 15. In 1 Corinthians 15, verse 10, Paul looks back at his life and he sees the result of his belief in God's grace. He says, "By the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace which was bestowed upon me was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than them all, but not I, but the grace of God which was with me." Paul's life was totally shaped and formed by God's grace. He was who he was because of that grace. To be a Christian is to be formed and moulded by the experience of God's grace. Grace means a free gift. People give gifts in the world because they expect something back in return or because they see some benefit for themselves personally. God's grace, God's gift, is not like that. He offers us forgiveness and salvation, not on the basis of our works, but it is available totally free to whoever can believe that he is offering it. That's so wonderful that if we believe it, we cannot be passive to it. We want to respond, to show our gratitude, to reflect and live with that same grace and love which we have been shown. And that's what happened to Paul, who is really a model Christian, a pattern, as he says, for all who would afterwards believe in Jesus. He says that because he felt that he'd been shown more grace than anyone else, he therefore worked harder than anyone else. His works for Jesus, his labour, were not in order that he might be saved, as if he had to achieve up to a level after which he might be saved. No, we, like Paul, are saved by grace. And so we labour, we work in appreciation of that grace. Our work is to be directly motivated by that grace. To the point we can say with Paul that it is not we who are doing that work, but it is God's grace doing the work through us. Salvation is not of works, it is of grace. But the more you believe that, the more humbly confident you are that really you will be saved, that you will live forever and ever with Jesus, the more you will want to do things for him in gratitude.